Hi friends, we'll discuss about United Nations organization. As you know, the UN is the international organization which focuses international cooperation, international harmony, international peace and establishment of world classical happiness. As you know, we have already discussed so many things regarding your United Nations organization, like all the main bodies of United Nations, and like your General Assembly and your Security Council, Trusteeship Council, International Court of Justice, many things. And we'll discuss today about the languages of United Nations organization. Actually, what is a language? Language means the principal instrument for communication. It may be individual, it may be a country, it may be United Nations organization or anything in this world. And without language, the United Nations are the highest body in the international sphere cannot be well defined. So in the United Nations Charter also, which was signed in June 26, 1945, it was decided that we should be abided by those rules and regulations and those motto, those philosophy of United Nations organization. Because this world has suffered a lot after the First and Second World War. And United Nations was established for promoting peace and harmony. So let me clear that in today's class we'll discuss about the languages of United Nations organization. What are those languages actually? You see, there are five permanent members and there should be some people think that five languages should be there. But actually there are six languages in United Nations organization. Like your French, Arabic, Russian, Spanish, Chinese and English also. And I have developed one technique for all of you, that is FARS. What is that FARS actually? F-A-R-S-C-E, FARS. Actually FARS, being an Indian, I have to say that FARS is a word, gossiping word in Indian local language. So I thought that, okay, let me introduce our local gossiping language, that is FARS, with United Nations organization, so that anybody can understand this. What is this FARS actually? You just see, F-A-R-S-C-E. So this FARS is an acronym. Actually, this is one acronym for languages of Indian international organization, UNO. FARS language. Consider that UNO has FARS language. What is this FARS actually? You see, F stands for French, A stands for Arabic, right? R stands for Russia, S stands for Spanish, C stands for Chinese. Actually, Chinese Mandarin. Let me clear that Chinese Mandarin is the highest spoken language all over the world. Actually, China has highest population in this world. So, Chinese Mandarin is one of the languages. And this is your, as usual, English. So, please remember this first. F-A-R-S-C-E. So that this acronym can help you to memorize the United Nations language. And there are certain languages also in International Court of Justice, so we'll discuss later. But for time being, just remember this FARS. That means French, Arabic, Russian, Spanish, Chinese, Mandarin. Actually, it is mentioned as Mandarin. So I have done this Chinese Mandarin. The last one is English, right? So hence, in this connection, I have to mention one important thing that it may be International Court of Justice, it may be United Nations organization, it may be any country throughout the world, you will find official languages. Suppose the official languages of India is your Hindi. And sometimes we have seen that English is also one of the official languages of India. Suppose Egypt, you will find Arabic. Even suppose in Spain, Spanish. In Australia, English you will find. Even also African countries, Swahili language, all those languages, they are playing a vital role. So, like any country, it may be Canada, it may be USA, it may be UK, it may be Russia, it may be India, it may be Egypt, it may be any African countries, anything, any country you think, there must be one official language. Why official language actually? Why official language? Because without official language, the motto, the sense of government, sense of those countries, sense of those organizations cannot be well defined. And with language that can be developed, that can be targeted for future perspective, future generation, future development. So without language, without official language, no organization can communicate with other organizations, even also employees, even also member states, member nations, member countries. So language is very important in individual life, also in organizational life. So the United Nations Organization decided that, okay, we should have one language, that is first, that there are six official languages. Thank you very much. Wish you happy learning. Thank you.